Hey, it's Fran, again, in the lab, Fran Lab. I know some people don't like me singing the introduction, but it's what I do. It's why you're here. So, I wanted to show off this. This is my working prototype for a new kind of display. It's actually a very old kind of display. I wanted to come up with a way to make a 3D printable, large-sized digital display that would be easy to just print and use without having to do complicated second steps like light pipes or other kinds of processes that you have to do usually with a 3D printed 7-segment display. Now, I've done this other project, which I haven't done a video on yet, but I've had some experimentation in doing 7-segment displays with 3D printing, and I was using light pipe technique with that, and I still have yet to finish that project, but in the middle of doing my second prototype for that light pipe project, which is yet to be completed, I came up with an idea to do this completely different kind of display, and this is it. There are no light pipes in this. This is a light box display. Now, I've shown lots of different kinds of displays throughout my channel, and this varies from all of them in the sense that there's no solid conduit for the light. It's basically just a light box where each segment has its own little enclosed box that lights up, and rather than having a light pipe, the segments are just segment-shaped windows that allow you to look into the box. So I'm using my really cool custom-made BCD 7-segment clock driver box, my bench counter, to drive this. And I'm going to show you the display all around. Get out of the stand. So it's sort of deceptive about the size. You can see my hands here, how big the size is, you know, compared to a multimeter. It's kind of big, and I'm only using one LED per segment for this. And then I have the driver actually mounted on the back here, just using a 4711 seven segment from BCD. Driver. I made this in two parts. Created it in AutoCAD, a frontal portion and a back portion. Two pieces. They come together with these two little tight fit. I've got a couple of holes in the face side and a couple of extended pins in the back side. And I have a hole through the pin to allow you to use a set screw that can actually go through the whole display and mount the display onto a backing piece. But the two pieces come together in alignment, and I printed out the sections in my printer. They're a bit gnarly when they first come out of the printer. They require a lot of cleaning and touching up by hand. Okay, there's the two pieces. The LEDs are mounted in the back, and this is the light box section in the front. So, no light pipes, it's just empty space. But you can see it's got these dividers in here which separate the sections. Now, what I had to do with this, because I printed it with a pretty dark material, I found that printing with white PLA, it just basically is like a diffuser. It's not really opaque at all when you put an LED in it. And when I tried my other light pipe design, when I printed it in white PLA, the whole thing just lit up like a light bulb. It was like putting Christmas tree lights in a trash bag is kind of what it looked like. So I printed this with a darker metallic material, and I had to paint a little bit of white paint in there just so that the surfaces would actually reflect the light rather than absorb it. I've got to find a better PLA. I wish there was like a lighter colored PLA that was actually completely opaque, but I haven't found it yet. But the actual supports for the frontal sections actually are also the separation walls for the various boxes for the segments. And I've actually got two LEDs for the center segment, and they kind of share that middle segment. And I probably can't stop this down. It's probably just overwhelming the camera with the lights, but let me shut this off here. All right. So I ended up, because of the way I had to manufacture this in several sections with this prototype, I actually laid a piece of tape that I could pierce the LEDs through and then solder them to the board on the back. It was really the only way I could assemble this prototype. I think ultimately what I'd like to do, though, is have the a circuit board that's incorporated into the display. If the circuit board had a white solder mask on it, then you can just solder the LEDs directly to it and then just have the circuit board be a part of the, basically the backing panel would be the circuit board. You know, that's, I guess, ultimately how something like this would really work. But again, yeah, I just used two LEDs for the center segment, which actually works out because if you actually calculate the total volume of each segment, the center segment has twice the volume, so twice the amount of light, so same number of photons per cubic centimeter. You could kind of calculate it that way for the brightness, and the whole thing goes together really snugly, like so. And so what you're actually looking at, when you're looking at the display, you're actually just looking at the inside of the box being illuminated. But you can see that, like, now after I made this prototype, I saw that I should have made these front boxes deeper. If these front boxes were like 5 millimeter or 7 millimeters thicker, this segment and this segment would look the same from the side angle, you see. So in my version 2, that's one of the changes I'm going to make. But you can see that the side angle viewing is actually quite good with the light box. I don't think there's any complaints there. Like I said, if that inner box were deeper, then you would be looking at the reflection off of the inner box surface rather than being able to look inside and see the light. So that's one improvement. Also, I think if people experiment with this light box idea, then I'm sure that people could come up with different kinds of internal geometry for different kinds of sources, light sources. So surface mount LED versions and, you know, different configurations of the internal geometry to improve or amplify the distribution of the light in the segment, other than just simple reflection the way that I've done it. So this is the basic idea, and I'd really like to see what people can do with this. One thing that I'm confident about and what I want to experiment with is that this idea, this concept, is very scalable. So you should be able to make displays of any size, even like human size, with this kind of light box concept. I have some ideas in mind for making some very large displays using this light box theory. And I think the prototype, it's not perfect. Like I said, there are some things that I definitely will change in the Type 2. But it's really, I think, for what it is, it works very, very well. I'm looking at different platforms to be able to upload and put up my STL files for various 3D objects so that people, if they look at my video and say, oh, I want to try that too, and they've got a printer that they can just go down, download the files and scale it and print it right on your own printer. My printer is not a very big one. I think at the maximum is like 9 inches is like the biggest like object that I can make on my printer. But nowadays 3D printers, they come in huge bed sizes, so you could scale it up and make displays pretty much as big as your printer bed. So anyway, that's it, and thanks. I'll be back very soon. I got that other project that I really want to finish. It's actually over there sitting on my light box, If you don't follow me on Twitter, but you like my experiments, you should, because Twitter is where I put the little hints of things that I'm doing, and I've posted pictures of this project and other projects while they're in the midst of being put together. Some of these projects take weeks or months or years, so if you do want to see what I'm up to, Twitter is one place where I kind of do that, update that every day. I also want to thank my patrons for hanging in with me through my many months long moving experience. I lost the storage space that was absolutely jammed full of stuff, including all the stuff I got from the UPenn Hall. And I had to vacate that space, which was a hassle. I had to move stuff here and move stuff to my wood shop. And then I got a new storage space, and then I had to move a lot of stuff out of the wood shop and out of here and back into this new space. And then I had to clean up the shops, and then I finished building in the wood shop. So that was a process that took several months. And during that time, I really wasn't really doing projects or anything. So thanks for sticking with me and holding in there and continuing to support the Fran Lab and the new wood shop, which I'm going to be doing stuff over there too. So thank you. Anyway, I'll see you soon. I'm Fran. Bye.